We are going to learn the same interference phenomena in the case of double slit with the help of wavefront theory. Are you clear? These are all the crest points. These are all the trough points. So let us imagine a source which is kept very closer to the double slit. Okay. So these two points, they are equidistant from the main source. Are you clear? From the source, the light is emitted in the form of the wave. The light should have the crest point and trough points. Now I am going to draw the wavefront for the crest points. So I am going to draw the first wavefront for crest with the help of the continuous line. Are you clear? With the help of the compass, we are able to draw the arc, continuous arc. This is the wavefront drawn for crest. Are you clear? First I will draw all the wavefront for crest points. Later I will draw the wavefront for trough points. See here one crest is there. Okay, in between these two crests, one trough is there. Now I am drawing the crest only for crest points. So I am going to draw the second crest. I am going to draw the third crest. Okay, so like that we can draw. Okay, now I am going to draw the trough points. For trough points, I have to draw the Now I am going to draw the wavefront for trough points. Okay. How to draw? We have to draw the arc. Okay. Draw the arc. This is the wavefront for trough. This is the wavefront for trough points. This is the wavefront for trough points. Look at that. It is made to incident on the double slit. After incidence, what will happen now? These two, they will act as the coherent source. A point and B point both are equidistant from the S. Therefore, the wave reaching A and the wave reaching B, in between them, there won't be any phase difference. The wave exactly reaching A and wave reaching B, both of them, they will be in phase. You have to understand that. Now, these two sources, they will act as the coherent source. Are you clear? The wave originating from A, the wave originating from B, they should not be, is it clear, any out of phase. They should be in phase. That's why the double slit method is used. Are you clear? This double slit method, that one provides you the two coherent sources. Make a note. Are you clear? So here, these two slits, therefrom the light is originating now. These two sources, they act as the coherent sources. Are you clear? This one was introduced by Thomas Young. This double slit method was introduced by whom? Thomas Young. Now these two sources, these two holes, slits, they are going to act as the coherent source. Okay. Now I am going to draw the wavefronts from the A source and B source. Later we are going to see how they are going to interfere. First I will draw the wavefronts for crest which is originating from which one? That A source. So this is the first crest. Definitely after the crest there will be a trough. So first I will complete the crest part. Are you clear? First I will complete the crest part. So this is the next crest from A. This is the next crest from A. Okay. So like that we can draw. From B also the wave is originating. Are you clear? From B also the wave is originating. We can draw few more for better understanding. Okay. So all are originating from A. From B also the same diameter should be taken, only then you will get the accuracy. So this is the wavefront originating from B. I have drawn the wavefront for crest. Same diameter must be taken. Okay, so this is the second crest wavefront. here this is the diameter of the crust in the first one, same must be taken. So patiently if you draw this, you will get the exact diagram. Are you clear? So I have drawn the wavefront for the all the crust points. Okay. So next one is, next we have to draw the wavefront for the trough. Now I am going to draw the wavefront for the trough. This is the first wavefront for the A source. Same diameter should be taken. Now I am going to draw the wavefront for the trough. Are you clear? The next wavefront for the trough must be drawn for A source. Here also we have to draw the wavefront for the trough for the second source. Here the third wavefront for the trough to be drawn. All orange lines, they are showing the wavefront for the troughs. Here also we have to draw. Okay. So Thomas Young, he has explained this interference with the help of wavefront phenomena. Okay. So we have to follow what he has told. Okay, so now you are able to understand that here the wavefront of the crust and trough both are interfering with one another. I will mark the points where the crust and crust are meeting, where the trough and trough are meeting. Observe the points very keenly. I will tell you one simple formula. Look at here, wherever trough and trough when they are meeting, there you can observe the constructive interference. Wherever crust and crust when they are meeting, there also constructive interference will happen. Wherever trough and crust or crust and trough when they are meeting, there you can observe the destructive interference, that is dark band will be created. In the case of constructive interference, which band will be created? Bright band or bright fringe will be created. Now you observe the wavefront diagram. I am marking the markings very keenly. Is it clear? You observe. I am going to mark the markings here. This is the point where two crusts they are meeting. This is the point where the two troughs are meeting. Are you clear? This is the point where the two crusts are meeting. This is the point where the two troughs are meeting. Here two crusts are meeting. This is the point where the two troughs are meeting. So crust crust, trough trough. Crest crest, trough trough. Crest crest, trough trough. Crest crest. Clear? All are meeting now. These points to be connected now. Okay. With the help of scale, we have to connect these points. Are you clear? Very important one. These points to be joined together. Are you clear? When these two points are, when all the points are connected, there you can observe the central bright band. Which one can be seen? The central bright fringe can be observed. This is the point, is it clear? This is the point which is equidistant from A and B. If you measure the distance from A and B, is it clear? You will get the same distance. The wave from A and wave from B, is it clear? Both may not have the phase difference in between them. So when A reaches this point, middle point P, when B reaches the middle point P, is it clear? Without any phase difference, both the two rays they will reach. There won't be any path difference, there won't be any phase difference, is it clear? When they reach and superpose at point P. Therefore, central bright band, very important one, central bright band or central bright fringe will be created here. Make a note. Are you clear? In the interference pattern, the middle pattern will be in the form of central bright band. Make a note. And then now I am going to mark the other points. Look at that. Here crest and troughs are meeting. crest and troughs are meeting, crest and trough, crest and trough, crest and trough. So now all the points to be joined together. When all the points are joined together, you will get the first dark band. First dark band you will be getting. Dark fringe will be created. First dark band will be created. Look at the point here. Here, crest and trough are meeting. Crest and trough, crest and trough, crest and trough. When all the points are connected together, you will get approximately I am connecting. So here also, you will be getting the first dark band. Make a note, on either side of the central bright band, the clear two dark bands will be created, dark fringes will be created. Are you clear? This one should be called as, what is this? Central bright band. The nearby dark band should be called as, what is this? Minimum, or we can call it as first dark band, first dark band. Now again you mark the points. Crest and crest are meeting, trough and trough are meeting, crest and crest, trough and trough. When these points are connected, so clear, approximately I am connecting, you will get the first maxima. This is called as first maxima. First bright band you will get. First bright band you will be getting. Are you clear? First maxima you will be getting. Like that, put a marking here. Crest and crest points are connected. Trough and trough are meeting here. And then crest and crest are meeting. Trough and trough are meeting. Crest and crest are meeting. Now you connect all the points together. What you are getting? There you are getting the first bright band. Are you clear? So like that we can mark all the points of the crest and crest point and trough and meeting points on the screen. You will be getting a pattern. So here in the center, there you can observe the central bright band. On either side of the central bright band, you are able to observe the first dark band. After that, you are able to observe the first bright band. Here you can observe the first bright band. After that, you will be getting the second dark band. You will get here, you will be getting the second dark band. So few fringes on either side of the central bright band. Here few fringes will be appearing. Here also few fringes will be appearing. Are you clear? The pattern is clear on the screen. Is clear? That one will be having alternative dark and bright band. In the fringe system, in the pattern, interference pattern system, in the middle, which band will be there? Central bright band can be observed. Okay. So I have explained how the double slit, it acts as the coherent source. I have explained how the interference takes place between the waves. Certainly how the interference that could be explained with the help of the wavefront theory, everything was explained. Okay.